A Quezon City court junks a perjury case filed by former National Security Advisor Hermenes Esperon Jr. against 10 human rights activists. They include the National Coordinator of Rural Missionaries of the Philippines, the Chairperson and Secretary General of Carapatan, and the Secretary General of Gabriela. Esperon's complaint filed in 2020 claimed that the activists lied under oath in a 2019 writ of amparo petition that the groups filed against him, then President Rodrigo Duterte, and several other government officials. But the Quezon City Court ruled the prosecution failed to establish beyond reasonable doubt that all accused made a willful and deliberate assertion of a falsehood.
The Philippine House of Representatives set to begin today its hearing into the air travel mess on New Year's Day. The Civil Aviation Authority of the Philippines says it's also preparing for a separate hearing by the Senate this coming Thursday. On January 1st, thousands of passengers were affected after the unprecedented failure of GAAP's traffic management system.
We've been working on this the past several days. In fact, sleepless nights, we've been meeting not only with the secretary, with the undersecretary, but the entire staff to give us the updates, to give us the findings, and to make sure that we give accurate information. We will not be holding any information at all. Sa amin lang ilalabas namin kung ano nangyari.
For an aviation industry expert, it's high time to revisit the training program of pilots to make sure they are ready for unexpected air travel disruptions.
It looks like it's an unthinkable scenario, but we still train for it.
Yes.
But now, it seems na hindi siya unthinkable, right? So now, let's make a regular training out of it. Maybe before you just visit this every 3 years. Now, I think we will have to revisit it every year or every twice a year.
The Philippine Energy Department is seeing thin power reserves for the Luzon grid. The agency also defends its call for demand-side management to ease pressure on the power grid. Avila Chico has the details.
Oil firms have announced a rollback in fuel prices effective Tuesday. Diesel will be lower by 2 pesos and 80 centavos per liter, gasoline by 75 centavos per liter, and kerosene by 210. The Department of Energy says fears of global recession is the main driver in the drop in imported fuel prices.
Meron namang mga reason na para bumaba siya, di ba? Meron ding reason para tumaas. But still, meron pang nangibabaw ngayon yung announcement ng global recession. Kapag global recession at tuloy-tuloy ang pagbaba ng demand, magpossibilidad na magtuloy-tuloy din ang pagbaba ng presyo.
Meanwhile, the Energy Department says based on projections for 2023, there will be no red or yellow alerts in the Mindanao and Visayas power grid. The problem is with the Luzon grid. With a projected forced outage of 500 to 600 megawatts, 8 months of 2023 will have yellow alerts or thin power reserve, which can lead to problems with electricity supply.
Sana wala tayong sudden outage because we have, let's say, one plant na biglang nasira, magkaka-red alert tayo nun at sudden on. Yung sa mga dapat sana ay yellow alert lang, pag sinabayan niya na biglang may nasira na planta, magkaka-red alert tayo.
The DOE pushes for demand-side management to minimize pressure on the power grid.
There are also things that are within our control. So doon sa kaya nating i-control, marami tayong energy efficiency tips, hindi lang sa behavior nga, kundi pati sa pagpili ng appliances, pati sa pagdisenyo ng mga building or mga pag-check, no? Kung saan sumisingaw yung lamig.
Energy Secretary Rafael Otilia defends the government stance in relying on demand-side management instead of erecting and running more power plants to overtake demand.
Hindi natin dapat tingnan yung demand-side management na parang panakip butas lamang. Dapat ito ay nagiging natural element or embedded already in our entire management system.
The DOE says it takes years to build a power facility, while demand-side management, though at the mercy of consumers, has immediate effect. For 2023, the DOE sees more than 1,000 megawatts additional power supply, mainly from solar and coal power plants. Alvin Olchico, ABS-CBN News.